Good morning all. Today we are going to discuss about the skewing of the rotor slots. So why we should do the skewing of the rotor slots and what are its effects on the performance of your machine. So before going to this, let us see if you are not skewing your rotor slots, what things are going to happen. Let us assume both my stator and rotor has the slotting. So I am taking the stator. The stator is having a slotting like this. This is my stator and this is my air gap. And this rotor also has the slotting. So rotor slotting may not be exactly same as the stator slotting. Let us assume the rotor slotting is there. This is my rotor. So now whenever the rotor is rotating, let us assume the rotor is rotating in this direction. So you can see at a particular instant, here the reluctance is less and here the reluctance is more. So after some instant, this motor will move by some distance. So automatically this will come to this point. And this may move ahead, so we can tell that again reluctance is changing, or we can tell that as a rotor is moving with respect to the stator, as the air gap between the stator and rotor is changing, because the rotor is changing, so automatically air gap is changing continuously, so there will be continuous fluctuations in the resultant flux. There is continuous fluctuations in the resultant flux. Whenever there are continuous fluctuations in the resultant flux, automatically there will be continuous fluctuations in the torque that is produced. So this gives rise to the effect called as the humming or the whistling noise in your machine. That's why, because of the stator and rotor slotting, if they are parallel, you will get the humming noise in your motor. This is because of the continuous variation of the reluctance at a particular point because of the motion of your rotor. This is the first effect. And the second effect, at a particular instant, let us assume this, because here the reluctance is less and when it moves the reluctance is changing. So always your machine want to maintain the low reluctance path. So what your stator will do, your stator will try to lock the rotor teeth. That means this teeth will try to lock with this teeth. Because of that, it will try to pull it back. So it produces one extra force. So that force will oppose your original torque. So that also will create the problem in your machine. This is the second one. And the third one we have seen in the last class, the what will be the effect of the slot harmonics. Because of the slotting, the harmonics will be produced. Those harmonics are called as the slot harmonics. So these are the three consequences of keeping a stator and the rotor parallel to each other. So what is the solution for this? I want to remove those slot harmonics and I want to make my machine as smooth as possible. So to get this, I am just going to skew my rotor slot. So what is the need of this? So before proceeding to let us first see how the EMF will be produced in a normal machine. So if you are taking this as a north pole, you take as a south pole. Generally, I am taking one conductor is under the north pole, another is under the south pole. Generally, they are connected together and the output is taken like this. Let us assume in the north pole, the EMF induced is like this, this side plus and minus. Let us assume EMF induced in each coil side is 5 volts. So in the second side, because this is under the north pole, so EMF induced will be opposite. So this will become 5 volts, or you can tell your terminal voltage will be equal to 2 times of the voltage induced in each side. So the gap between the poles we call by pole pitch, and gap between two sides of a coil is called as coil span, because when two conductors are connected together, it forms a coil. So in this case, it is obtained like this. Let us assume there is my north pole, there is my south pole, and there is my north pole. So there are two pole pitches between these two. This is one pole pitch and this is my second pole pitch. So two pole pitch. Now let us assume the conductors which are at a gap of two pole pitch, that means having a coil span of two pole pitch are connected together, what will be my output? So if you take the output, this will be the direction of the EMF induced. Let us take this as plus 5 volts. So same type of EMF will be induced, because here also it is north pole. So this will become plus minus, here also it is 5 volts. What is the net voltage? The net voltage becomes equal to 0. So the basic observation from this, I observe that when the two adjacent conductors are placed at two pole pitch distance, the net EMF induced will be equal to 0. And in the last class, we have seen whatever is the harmonics that are produced of the tooth harmonics, that harmonics will increase the number of poles in your the field distribution, because our field distribution is disturbed. So that we can analyze as having the number of poles will be equal to the order of the harmonic multiplied by the actual number of poles. Those many poles will be produced. So now what I can do, I am taking my rotor slots. Let us assume here there is a north pole, here there is a south pole and here there is a north pole. So whichever conductor comes under the north pole, let us assume the EMF induced is like this, under the south pole EMF is like this, under the north pole EMF is like this. So this is for a particular case of a particular harmonic content. So let us take this as this is my harmonic pole pitch. So this is between one pole, second pole, third pole. So I can tell that this is two harmonic pole pitch. If it is fundamental, it will be normal. If it is harmonic, I have to multiply the number of poles will be equal to the harmonic content frequency multiplied by the actual number of poles. If you want the complete clarification of this, you can refer to my previous lecture. I have explained the slot harmonics there and I explained how the number of poles will increase. So now what I will do, I will keep my the rotor conductor in such a way, or the rotor conductors will be like this. It will start from any one particular pole pitch and it will extend up to the next pole pitch. That means this will be my rotor conductor. In this way I keep it. You can see here this is spreading from a north pole to another north pole. So the net EMF induced, you can see here under this north pole EMF will be one direction, under south pole EMF another direction, again north pole another direction. So the net EMF induced will be equal to zero. So what we do, we turn the conductor in the direction in such a way that it covers two pole pitches. So this is, that means we are shifting your conductor away from your parallel axis, you are shifting at some angle. So this is called as the skewing of the rotor slots. I am explaining once again, because of the skewing of the rotor slots, the net EMF induced for that particular harmonic content can be made equal to zero. That's why skewing of the rotor slots is done. Let us take one example to completely clarify this one. So I am taking one example. So if this your machine is having a 4 pole machine and I want to remove my 17th harmonic. So if 17th harmonic is to be eliminated, this 17th harmonic will have a pole pitch of 17 into 4. That means there will be 68 harmonic poles will be there. For this particular harmonic, the number of poles will increase to 68. So for this particular harmonic, I can calculate my harmonic pole pitch. This harmonic pole pitch will be total angle is 360 degrees divided by, now the poles becomes 4 times of the 17, or this will become equal to 68. So this will be in mechanical degrees. Then so the angle of skew, I told if you want to eliminate, we have to take as 2 times the harmonic pole pitch. We have just proved it. So I have to maintain 2 times the harmonic pole pitch is 360 degrees divided by 4 into 17 mechanical. This way I can do, or in a generalized way, I can tell the angle of skew should be equal to 720 degrees divided by number of poles into order of harmonic in mechanical degrees, where P is equal to number of poles and N is the order of slot harmonics. Or sometimes it may be required to represent in electrical degrees. We know that theta electrical is equal to theta mechanical divided multiplied by pair of poles. So this will be 720 divided by Pn into P by 2. If you multiply this, you will get it as 360 degrees divided by N. This is in electrical degrees. Either you can represent in mechanical degrees or electrical degrees. So now what is the consequence of this skewing? So consequence of this skewing, you can go back to this. You can see when the rotor is rotating, let us assume at a particular stator point. So first this tip will come, because let us assume the rotor is rotating like this. First tip will come, after some time this part will come, after some time this part is coming, after some time this part, after some time this part is coming for a particular point on the stator. So we can tell that this conductor, these conductors are connected in series. I can take this as small, small conductors. They are connected in series, which are distributed over the span of your length. So this is nothing but the distribution of your winding. This I can resemble something like distribution of the winding. So we can tell that because of skewing of the rotor slots, and as a rotating flux cuts one end of the bar first, and then gradually it proceeds across the length of the bar, and it finally it cuts the end of the bar. So that's why this skewing effect I can take as a spread. So that I am representing by the distribution factor Kdn, because of the skewing, will be equal to sine of the spread. The spread will be equal to n times of theta s, divided by 2, n times of theta s divided by 2 divided by 1 by 2 times of n times of theta s, where theta s will be equal to the angle of skew, where theta s is equal to angle of skew and n is the order of slot harmonics. It is the angle of slot harmonics. So, now this will be my distribution. Because of this distribution factor also, the whatever EMF is induced, you have to multiply with the distribution factor. So, your net EMF will further decrease than this one. So, this is what we observe from here. So, let us see what is the effect of skewing of the rotor slots. Before going to the effect, let us try to solve one numerical so that this concept will be completely clear to you. So, I am taking one example, a three-phase 6-pole alternator has 36 slots. What slot harmonics do you expect in the output wave if it is desired to eliminate load order harmonic, find the angle of skew. It is also asked, investigate the effect of this skew on the higher order harmonic. So, this I can solve like this. So, we know the value of Fs. Fs is equal to, we have studied in last class, this is F into 2s by p plus or minus 1. This is the frequency of slot harmonics. So, this will become 2 into the S is 36 because there are 36 slots, number of slots, and number of poles are equal to 6 plus or minus 1 times of your fundamental frequency. So, you can get the frequency as 11f and 13f. That means the order of the harmonics that comes is 11 and 13. These two harmonics will come. Now, I want to remove the lower order harmonics. It is asked to find the angle of skew. So, the angle of skew I can find from equal to 360 degrees divided by the order of the harmonic is 11. So, this becomes 32.727 degrees electrical degrees. So, now I want to find what is the distribution factor for this 11th harmonic. So, 11th harmonic will be sin n times of theta s divided by 2 divided by 1 by 2 times of n times of theta s. The distribution factor we have discussed before. So, this is based on the distribution factor. So, this becomes sin of 180 degrees divided by, because sin of this is sin of this angle multiplied by m sin of the angle will come. So, when the angle is very small, I can neglect this. This we have discussed in the basics of distribution factor. You can refer there. So, if you substitute this, this will become equal to pi. So, this will become equal to 0. So, now calculating for the case of 13th harmonic. So, this becomes sin of 13 into 360 degrees divided by 11 into 2 divided by 13 times of 2 pi divided by 11 into 2. So, if you calculate this one, this will become 0.1456, this value we get. So, you can see here, this fraction is 0.14. So, we can tell that the value of the EMF induced because of the 13th harmonic also reduced considerably along with elimination of the 11th harmonic. That means, by properly skewing my rotor slot, I can eliminate the harmonic of any order. Along with that, the harmonics which are in the nearby order, so they will also get nullified because of skewing of the rotor slots. Now, let us try to summarize. What is the effect of skewing of the rotor slots? Effect of skewing of rotor slots. So, let us first see the advantages and then we will see the disadvantage. First one is, the advantage of the skewing of the rotor slots is, this harmonic torques which are produced because of the slot harmonics, they get nullified or become very less, and as a consequence of this, the vibration is less as well as the noise is less. That means, your machine operates at a silent speed. That is the advantage of the slot harmonics. This is a major advantage. But there are some disadvantages of the slot harmonics. What are those disadvantages of the slot harmonics? The disadvantage is, as the slot harmonics are not parallel, automatically the leakage reactance will increase. When the leakage reactance increases, the value of the starting torque as well as maximum torque will decrease. So this is the first effect. And the second one is, so now the slots are aligned at some angle. So it produces a force like this. So this force can be resolved into horizontal component and the vertical component also. Because of this, you can see there is a horizontal component of the torque also produced. So this horizontal component of the torque, so that will affect on your bearings, that may create the thrust on the bearings and your bearings may damage with time. So that is the first disadvantage. I hope this is clear. I am explaining once again. As the rotor slots are inclined at some angle, so there will be one component of the torque which will be parallel to your axis. So because of this parallel torque, it will try to pull your rotor out from the bearings, so in the axial direction. So that may create problem to your machine, even though this value may be very less. Then the third effect is, as the length is increased because of the skewing, the length is increased because it should cover the more length. So automatically the resistance increases. When the resistance increases, then the I square R losses in your rotor increases. When the I square R losses increases, your efficiency will fall down. This is the second disadvantage of this. So I have discussing or summarizing all the things. The advantage of going for the skewing of the rotor slots is, because of skewing of the rotor slot, the harmonic torques are completely eliminated. Because of elimination of the harmonic torques, the motor will run more smoothly, and the tendency of rocking of the rotor slots or the sound or the noise will be very less. That is another advantage. So this can be explained like this, because in this case your reluctance or the air gap is made uniform because of skewing of the rotor slots. When R is made uniform, so automatically your flux becomes uniform. Because of this, your torque becomes uniform. So automatically your operation will be quiet. That is the main reason for this. Now coming to the disadvantages, the leakage reactance will be more as they are inclined at some angle. So automatically this affects your starting torque and the maximum torque. As it is inclined at some angle, it produces a torque in the axial direction also that may create the force on your bearings. So that is the second one. And the third one, as the length is more, the resistance will be more. As the resistance is more, because as the length is more, automatically resistance will be more, because R is equal to rho L by A, the length is more. So because of that, I square R losses increases, or we can tell that efficiency will fall down. And practically it is observed that whatever advantages we are getting by skewing the rotor slots are far dominating the disadvantages of skewing of the rotor slots. That's why practically if you take any machine, either induction machine or a synchronous machine, always the rotor will be skewed at some angle. So that rotor skewing will depend on what is the order of the harmonic we are getting. So you have to keep it equal to two pole pitches for that particular harmonic component. I hope this is clear to you. If you still have any queries, you can leave your comments in the comment section below. I will answer to your queries from there. Thank you. Thank you very much.